Hey dolls, hey y'all, it is Melissa Q. Thanks so much for watching. Thank you for coming by again, and I hope you guys are enjoying these project pans. It's definitely something that I am going to take into 2018 on my channel, and today we are doing Finish 9 by New Year's. This is a collab with my girl here, Kristen K, here on YouTube, and it was such a joy. If you didn't know, she was definitely one of the people that inspired me to start project panning, and I actually watched her probably for about a year before I started getting into project pan. I did start a few projects last year that were somewhat, to me, they were okay. They weren't as successful as my 2017, and so 2018, I definitely can see the ball rolling and really getting into project pan. I definitely want to bring a flair to it, and I do have a project pan coming up on January 3rd. It's another collab with one of my girls here on YouTube again. I want you to check it out because it is going to be pretty awesome. And I'm putting a spin to it. Let's get into the Finish 9 by New Year's. I am so excited about this. There were some items that I did get I actually emptied, but there are some other products that I really decided that I didn't like as much. So the first one that I actually finished was the Pixi Glotion Day Dew. As you can tell from the last video, which was update 1, I did start here and it is completely done. I really do enjoy this. To me, it is a dupe to the MAC Strobe Cream. I really did enjoy this a lot. It does have a scent, but it also has it's a brightening lotion, but I like that Pixi has like skincare properties. Not only is illuminating, but it does have a skincare property in it, and I really did enjoy it. I would repurchase it. I did talk about the first base, NYX First Base Primer Spray being finished, and yes, I would repurchase this. Unfortunately, I won't be repurchasing this in the near future because up until March, I am going on a no buy. Now you're going to see this. I am saying this update just because I want to let you guys know, like right now, that I did do, my birthday is in December, and I did get some gift cards for Christmas. So I did do some shopping. So you will see a haul, but that is already like all of my there are purchases that I've already made. The only purchase that I am going to support is my girl Alyssa Ashley, and that's a $6 lip gloss. That is it. I am done with my purchases right now for the next 3 months, and I am going to come with a video about that, but I am currently on a no buy. I do have products that I am going to do a haul on, but currently, as of right now, I am on a no buy. I've made all of my purchases for my birthday, and that's going to be a birthday and a Christmas haul, but that's a little bit later. I had to say that because you won't be seeing me purchase anything or coming with anything new on my channel if it's not from that haul. But this is really good. It reminds me of the Smashbox Primer Water. I already have that, and you're going to see that in another project pan. But I really did enjoy this, and I feel like it's definitely worth the buy. You get 2.02 ounces, which is 60 mil. It is really good, and to me, it's really good for people who don't like that silicone-y feel of primers on their face. This one is more of a hydrating, especially, and it does dry down, but I did like this a lot. The next product that I totally ran out of, which will be a repurchase, I actually have one already, and this is the Naked Skin by Urban Decay. This is their Peach Corrector. I really did enjoy this. As you can tell, I scraped the yin-yang out of this. I really do enjoy this. This is probably one of my favorite color correctors that's on the high-end scale. It does dry down. It has a wonderful applicator. I definitely can see myself repurchasing this over and over again. This is a holy grail product. I really did enjoy that. And like I said, I love that about Project Pan, is that you really get to find out what you really like. I do prefer my color correctors in one or a tube form. I don't like them in pots anymore. I know you guys saw that my NYX color corrector was in a pot, that coconut one. And I really, really, really do enjoy that. But I'm finding some other ones. The Master Conceal by Maybelline in Apricot is a drugstore. So I don't think I'm going to be moving back to that, just because I have to dig my fingers in it and it changes the texture. And I feel feel like that these are more long-lasting and it stays true to the original texture that it originated from. So I really did enjoy that. The next product, let's talk about things that are old. This one I'm going to declutter. This is the Makeup Forever. This is the Aqua Rouge in number one, and this was in nude beige. If you can tell, I was here, and then by the first update I was here. If you can tell, it is actually changing colors. That is not a good sign. I really did enjoy this, but in terms of liquid lipsticks, I actually like the Artist better. This is a waterproof, and this one tends to get a lot more drier, and it does not look as flattering as the Artist liquid lipsticks. I know you guys probably saw on Instagram, and if I can post it in this video, I will show you. It was a red lip in that was the Artist liquid lipstick in the shade 401. I absolutely love that color, and I am not a red lip lover. And I actually wore that for the video. And actually 301 as well. 301 as well is one, it's either 301 or 103. I can't remember, but it's such a beautiful color, but I do prefer that formulation a lot better than this one. So these I'm probably going to declutter from my collection just because I really like the colors, but the texture of it, I just seem to gravitate more towards the Artist than the Aqua Rouge formulation. So I think I'm going to go ahead and declutter these. I'm probably going to, there's some I don't think I've opened. I'm probably going to send those to my sisters and, you know, someone that I can pass along that won't mind me if I swatch them or I've never worn them. So yeah, I'm going to pass on to these. This one is still going strong, the Kat Von D. I'm wearing it today. I'm actually going to put it in another project pan. And this is a liner that is a holy grail for me. I really do enjoy it. It's really easy to use. It has that mixer that you can tell it's still mixing the product. And this one's still going strong. So it's long lasting, by the way. It retails for like about $19 from Sephora. I really do enjoy it, but I'm passing it on and putting it into another project pan just because I want to use it up. Let's move on to this lip liner. I did not use it as much. Well, I did use it. I only sharpened once, but it's still the same size as before. And I will show you guys that picture again. If you want to check out my first update or my intro, I will link them over here, but there's no difference than that. But I really do enjoy this shade. I'm seeing what kind of shades that I prefer in my lip liners, and I love putting them in the project pans for that reason. I will be passing this on and putting this, I'll be keeping this probably in my purse. I do like this shade. So the next product that I have is the Lorac Perfection Concealer. I really didn't use this as much. It is high coverage, y'all. I do love this a lot, but because I was on vacation during the second update of this, I noticed that I like this for my special events. It's very high coverage. I don't have to use a color corrector. That's how high coverage this is. So I am going to actually keep this. It's oil free, paraben free, and it's fragrance free. I really did enjoy this, but I am going to put this back in my collection just because I noticed that this is not an everyday. This is a special event high coverage concealer, but I did get some use out of it, but I really didn't change from where it was. So I'm noticing what is considered like an everyday concealer versus a high coverage one. So this, it would be considered a regular, like a high coverage concealer. And something every day that I have been loving is the Glossier Stretch Concealer or the L'Oreal Pro. This is the Infallible Pro Glow Concealer. These are ones that are everyday. This is like very high coverage. This would be comparable to Pro Longwear Concealer. So that's how high coverage that is. So I am going to, I didn't use that, to be honest, I didn't use this much. So that was that was just that. Next, moving on to the NARS All Day Weightless Luminous. As you can tell, this was intro, this is update one, and this is the finale. I am almost done with this. I am gonna roll this over into a 2018 project pan. I really do enjoy this foundation. I would repurchase it. I did not know how to use it at first, but I'm so glad that I know how to use it. I absolutely love it. And yeah, I'll be putting this in another project pan. And the Stila All Over Shimmer. I do like this. Once I use this up, I am not going to repurchase this. I feel like that this is actually a brush, almost like a nail polish. I do not understand the applicator in this. I really wish that this would be in a pump, but I do like that you can brush it on. But once it hits the brush, the product has used up to the brush, you're still gonna have a lot of product, and I don't know how I'm gonna get that out. After that, I'm probably gonna declutter it, because that's just wasted product that I'm not gonna be able to get to, and because I know I'm gonna have to fight to get this out. But I did use this in a lot of my moisturizers. I do like this a lot, but I notice a applicator that I do like is the Temptu Liquid Glow. It's pretty much the same thing, and I might go ahead and end up decluttering this. I'm not sure, but see how this is a tube and it's plastic and it's squeezy? I'm gonna be able to get pretty much all of the product out of this. So, and it's a little bit more liquidy. This one is a little bit more thick, but I really do enjoy this. It does, it reminds me of the Marc Jacobs Do You Cover Drops, or the Illuminating Drops. It reminds me a lot of that, but I feel like I'm probably going to use this as much as I can, and then when it's done, it's just done. But I prefer something in a tube or a pump like this. So those are the type of liquid illuminators that I do like. Pumps and tubes, not a paintbrush. This is too weird. And I'm learning, that's one of the things that I need to look at before I purchase an item, just not to purchase it, but is it going to be easy for me to use? So those are all the products in my Finish 9 by New Year's. Don't forget to head over to Kristen's video and check out what her progress was. Thanks so much for watching, you guys, and I will see you in 2018 with another project pan. Thanks, guys. Bye, lovies.